On this page, we will explore cartilage, bone, and blood. All of them are connective tissues. And indeed, they do adhere to that very key characteristic of connective tissue. Remember that sentence, a few cells contained within an abundant extracellular matrix. We're going to start with cartilage. There are three types of cartilage: hyaline cartilage, elastic cartilage, and fibrocartilage. Hyaline cartilage is a very smooth and flexible type of cartilage. There's actually a lot of collagen in it, but it has this very glassy, pearly appearance. I think it looks kind of like a Monet painting, sort of like watercolor, washed looking, dreamy appearance, but that's my opinion. Hyaline cartilage sits on the top of all of the long bones of the body. Also, it composes the nose and the trachea. So within the wall of the trachea, you have these hyaline cartilage rings. Also, the costal cartilage, that's the cartilage that connects the ribs to the sternum. So overall, hyaline cartilage is sort of flexible, but also smooth, and provides a very nice surface around which bones can articulate. Elastic cartilage composes the ear and another structure in the larynx called the epiglottis. Elastic cartilage, because of all of its randomly positioned elastic fibers, can resist pulling forces in many directions. So because it's pretty sturdy and pretty firm, it can maintain a nice shape. So if you were to bend your ear over and then release it, your ear would bounce back to its original shape. And that's because this type of cartilage maintains shape. That's its function. Fibrocartilage composes all discs. So there are many discs in the body, the intervertebral discs. You have menisci, those are in the knees. Also, there is the pubic symphysis, which is a single disc between the two pubis bones. This specific type of cartilage resists compression. So it's got nice parallel bundles of fibers. You can kind of see it has a wavy, watery appearance. And the important thing to note about this tissue is that there's a stain that's specific for this tissue, and it's always going to look blue. Okay? Bone tissue is also connective tissue. It's a solid, so it composes your skeleton, and it arranges in these nice cylindrical units. Those units are called osteons. Important cells of bone tissue are osteoblasts, osteocytes, osteoclasts, and of course, the function of the skeleton is to provide a framework, but overall, bone tissue resists compression and torsion. Torsion is a twisting force. Lastly, blood connective tissue. It is found in your blood vessels. So blood is composed of cells. Those cells are erythrocytes, leukocytes, and platelets. And then the non-cellular extracellular matrix of blood is called plasma. Plasma is non-cellular. It's mostly water, but it also contains nutrients, waste, electrolytes, hormones, proteins, other signaling molecules. And so overall, blood is contained within the blood vessels and transports all of these cells and nutrients and molecules throughout the body. So connective tissue is extremely diverse. It ranges from tendons and ligaments to wrapping around organs to fat to bone to blood to cartilage. It really is the most abundant and diverse of all of the tissues.